All right, I would like to play first. All right, I feel like I can't mulligan this hand. It's got turn one necro, even though it does get hit pretty hard by force of will. Let's play Mox and play Mana Vault. I'm just operating on a vain hope that my opponent mental missteps the Mana Vault. Please mental misstep the Mana Vault. Oh, my opponent's thinking about it so hard. If my opponent does not mental misstep this Mana Vault, I'm in trouble. All right. Please don't have force of will. I'm just asking my opponent for all these very reasonable things. All right, there's the necro. Fingers crossed. And denied. All right, well, if my opponent has turn one mental misstep and force of will, I'm afraid there's not a ton I can do about it. If I draw a Griselbrand, I can Burning Wish for the show and tell, which would be nice. And other than that, I mean, I can draw an Oath of Druids. There are cards I can draw. Opponent is down three cards, as am I, so it's not horribly imbalanced. Well, there's the show and tell. So I can now Burning Wish. Now, there's not a whole lot I can Burning Wish for that really gets me anywhere, so let's just pass the turn. I could Burning Wish for Empty the Warrens at some point, but I kind of like casting that in the same turn. Maybe I'll just wait one turn. If I draw another decent spell, then maybe I just cast Burning Wish for Empty, just to kind of start the chain, because that way I can maybe go Mana Crypt, another spell, Empty for 6, and Empty for 6 might be sufficient. Plus my opponent might just counter to Burning Wish. That's happened before. Alright, let's cast Burning Wish. And see if that resolves. I could have played Mana Crypt City of Brass to play it on Flusterstorm, but I think I would rather just get my Burning Wish Flusterstorm, especially since Flusterstorm will often counter to whatever the thing is that you're trying to cast. Opponent's thinking pretty hard here. Let's see what they end up doing. That last game was close. Had to hit a Burning Wish off the... Oh, there's the Flusterstorm. Had to hit a Burning Wish off the Memory Jar, and then... Failing that, had my opponent not have the second bolt. But neither of those things happened, and I perished. All right, let's just play City of Brass. Griselbrand, not a terrible draw now. That's the other thing about Burning Wish, but your opponents are always scared of it. You cast it, they always just counter it, even if it's not necessarily clear that that's a problem. Ooh, what are we casting with Volcanic? We're just going for it. Bolting me. Interesting. That means my opponent does not have a young Pyromancer in play. Or, well, clearly doesn't have one in play. It means my opponent does not have a young Pyromancer coming anytime soon. Otherwise, you wouldn't just be firing off lightning bolts wildly. But, yeah, the Delver decks are tough. It's one of the reasons that, I'm trying the show and tell package in the sideboard. I don't know if it's good. I do like this deck in general, but it overdecks with a lot of cheap counterspells and even lightning bolts. Lightning bolts, annoying card. Alright, Gushing. Boom. I just could not play a deck with Gush without playing Fastbinded. I'm not saying they should be playing Fastbinded in that deck, I'm just saying I wouldn't play the deck because I want to cast Gush and Fastbinded a bunch of spells. I don't want to use Gush as just like an incremental card advantage machine here. Not my style. Top, huh? Yeah, that bodes well for me. Alright. Time to cast Show and Tell. Oh yeah. The show and tell bluff is great, because if your opponent has a counterspell, they're gonna counter it. And I have extra show and tell, alright. So it ended up being an actual pretty decent draw. I'm like threatening a Griselbrand for sure. Alright, opponent forced pitching time walk. See? Show and tell was great. It was a Hymn to Tarok right there. Of course, these Cities of Brass are adding up. I'm at not a lot of lives. And now my opponent's sold on me having Griselbrand in my hand, so get to keep that in mind. Just pass the turn. Might need that for like Storm Count or something. So, knowing that I'm playing against a deck with Lightning Bolts, I wonder if last game I was supposed to cast Necro instead, or cast Wheel instead of Necro. It's very possible. Just turn two, Wheel of Fortune. We'll keep that in mind. Alright, so opponent Gushing, having a Delver in play, which does mean I'm eventually going to be clocked. Alright, my hand's actually decent. As far as these things go, it's probably going to flip right away, since that's what Delvers do. Oh, it didn't. Nice. My hand is decent. I have a lot of mana available to me right now. I'm on 4, 6, 8 mana, so if I draw something like Mind's Desire, that's potential play. Bargain and Necro are getting pretty bad. Could technically cast Griselbrand. Let's cast Ponder. My opponent could have Mental Misstep, but I can't really sit here doing nothing. Alright. Well, 3 mana sources. I will shuffle that. What do I want to do here? I could cast Burning Wish. If it resolves, I could get Yawgmoth's Will. I could go Mox Jet, Dark Ritual, Mana Crypt, Yawgmoth's Will, Dark Ritual, Mana Vault, and do nothing. So let's just wait a turn here. And then cast Burning Wish next turn. Part of the problem is Burning Wishing for empty is no longer good enough, I don't believe. Because my opponent is likely going to be delving. My opponent did not crack the fetch land. So they saw a card that was not a spell. So they did not, Delver did not flip, but they also did not fetch. Alright. Are we casting like a Trigon Predator or an Edric or something? Or are we just sacking those fetch lands now? But sacking the fetch land now doesn't make that much sense. You've got a Delver, you get to peek at your top card. Might as well wait. Maybe my opponent's casting like a Gush. Don't really need to sack both fetches, but I'm at 10. And okay, it is a 3 drop, is my assumption here. Oh, young Pyromancer are leaving blue-green up. Interesting. Alright, here is... Let's see, do I have enough mana to do it all? I can play Mana Crypt. I can cast Show and Tell. And then that gets countered, and... Alright, I think this is my best shot here. Baiting my opponent into Flusterstorming this, and if, or forcing it. And if such a thing does happen, then I get to go Mox Jet. Alright, Force of Will, Pitching, Gush it looks like. Alright. And if my opponent had Flusterstorm, they would have Flusterstormed that, right? Well, that's the hope. Alright. Dark Ritual, Lion's Eye Diamond, tap this for red, black, or red and green, I guess. Cast Burning Wish. In response, sack Lion's Eye Diamond for red. My opponent has a counter, I'm just dead, but that's always been the case. I do get to show my opponent that in fact I had nothing that I could put into play off either Show and Tell. So that's pretty sweet. Cast Yawgmoth's Will, Ritual, Lion's Eye Diamond, Mana Vault, Ritual. I have enough mana, so let's sack Lion's Eye Diamond for blue. Cast Ponder. At this point, I'm looking for a Duress, even though I don't really need it, because I can't imagine my opponent has anything. Take Nature's Claim. Tap this, cast Burning Wish, and get Tendrils. And my opponent knows well and thoroughly that they Force of Will 2 Show and Tells that did absolutely nothing. And my opponent cited Nature's Claim, which I guess is, yeah, it makes sense. For Oathbreaker, for a second I was like, God, is my opponent going after Defense Grid? But no. All right, well, that was sweet. The Show and Tell plan worked perfectly. It's a 3-mana must counter. Nature's Claim also makes me not want to have Jar, by the way, since... You know, playing, often you'll tinker for Jar and pass the turn, and if you get a Nature's Claim, that is a, well, pretty jarring experience, as it were. Still don't want, I still think I have to take out Repeals. I like Repeal, but and it's good on Delver, but I think in order to make room for Show and Tells, I need to take out the Repeals. I wonder if my opponent's going to let Show and Tell resolve game 3 because I cast these two, you know, Raw Dog Show and Tells. That would be sweet. Because then I'd be getting value on both sides. I got value because my opponent forced 2 Show and Tells. Then I would get value because my opponent let a Show and Tell resolve when I actually have a Griselbrand. All right, let's do this.